Hello everyone, this is Mirzai from Cal Poly Pomona, and in this lesson we are going to learn how to develop a piecewise linear regression model in R. The example that we are going to investigate is the same example that we previously saw. It's the data set called Reynolds and is from chapter 4 of the book Essentials for Business Analytics. Previously, we developed a quadratic regression model for this data set. An alternative to a quadratic model is a piecewise linear model, where it's made of pieces of linear lines that are connected through common points. Now, to decide whether a quadratic model is better or a piecewise linear model, we can develop both and look into the R-square of each and see which one gives us a better R-square, because R-square tells us the amount of error that we are capturing by using the regressed line. For a piecewise linear model, we need to define a breaking point. This breaking point is called the knot value. In this example, we choose 90 as the breaking point. The selection of the breakpoint depends on the analyst. So you have flexibility to decide where you want to cut your line and start this next section of your linear line. If you do it right, you should be able to get a good R-square when you set up your linear model. The general form of the equation in regression that you develop for a piecewise linear model is given up here, which is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 multiplied by x minus knot value multiplied by dummy knot. Let's see what is the definition of knot value and dummy knot. Knot value is our breaking point. Please pay attention that k is not an exponent to x, but is an upper index. That's why we show it within parentheses. So in this case, the knot value is equal to 90. It means that we divide our data set at point x equal to 90 in two parts, and we try to develop a linear regression model for the points after 90 and the points before 90, and we want them to be connected at the point x equal to 90. Now, another variable that we need to determine is called dummy knot. Dummy knot is the flag or binary variable that is going to be 1 if the value of x is greater than the knot value and is 0 otherwise. To be able to run the regression model, we need to create a new column that represents this part of the equation. So as you see, in this part, we need x dummy and knot value. In the dataset Reynolds, we have the month since employment and the amount of sales based on the number of month that somebody has been employed. In this table, I don't show the scales sold, which is our y variable. I just showed x because my intention is to create this part of the regression model. So first, we need to generate the knot dummy. Basically, we want to flag everything that is greater than 90 as 1 and everything that is less than 90 as 0. So this is the column that shows my knot dummy. Now I have to create this section, which is x minus knot value. The knot value is 90, so this part basically is my x, which is month since employment. For example, for the first row is 41 minus 90, which is the knot value that I have. So in the next section, these values show me the amount of x minus the knot value, which is 90. Now, the next part is to simply multiply these two columns together, because that's what's shown in this part of the regression model. If we do that, this is the next column that we create. Basically, all the variables that have a dummy of 1, which are 3, is going to be reflected in the last column. So what's happening here is that basically we're adjusting the x value of these 3 points that are greater than 90 according to a new coordinate system, which starts at 90. So basically, you're trying to find the new x if there was a y-axis that starts at point 90. Now that I have created this part of the input to the regression model, I can start running my regression using this column in addition to x, because in my regression model, you have x and this part as the coefficient to beta 1 and beta 2. Therefore, these are the ones that we include in the regression model. So now I'm going to take this to R and implement the piecewise linear regression model in R. All right, so we are in R platform and we are trying to implement the piecewise linear regression model in R. The first step is to read the file that includes my data. Again, WD includes the work directory that I have. Now I set my work directory so I can point the directory of R to the folder that includes the file. The name of the file that we need is called Reynolds. It's very similar to the previous example.
So we're going to use read.csv and then put the name of the file, which is reynolds.csv. And then if I run this line of code, I bring the data set into my platform. You can highlight Reynolds and Control R or Control Enter or in Mac and see your data set that has been brought to the platform. For creating the piecewise linear regression model, and I'm going to write the equation that we have here. Y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 multiplied by month since employment, which is our x, plus beta 2 multiplied by x minus x naught. I put k into parentheses that shows that this is the naught value, multiplied by dummy naught, which is xk. So I put that without parentheses so we know that this is the dummy naught. So I'm going to create the dummy naught first for this piecewise linear regression model. If you remember, the dummy naught is going to be 1 if you have a variable or x that is greater than 90, otherwise it's going to be 0. I first create a vector with all the elements being 0 and then only change the one that are greater than 90 to 1. So this way, if I add a new column here, the length of this column should be equal to the length of scales sold or month employed. So I'm going to calculate the length of this column first and create a vector of 0, which is as long as the length of this column month employed. So I'm going to attach Reynolds here so I don't have to refer to Reynolds column every time I need to refer to them. So the next step is to create that vector that I mentioned, the vector of zeros. So I can say xk, which is the dummy naught, or you can just call it dummy naught so you know what variable is this one, is equal to a vector of 0, replicate 0, how many times? As many times as we have rows in month employed. So if I copy this column here, I can say replicate 0 according to the length of month employed. So as many as you have variable here. If I highlight this part and run it, you see that I get 15 because you have 15 rows here. So when I say replicate 0, it is going to create a vector of 0 that has 15 elements. So if I highlight dummy naught and run this part of code, you see that I have a vector that everything is 0. Now I want to make some of these elements equal to 1. The one that I need to change to 1 are the ones that have x greater than 90. So what I'm going to do next is that in dummy naught, so if I'm going to copy this part, in dummy naught, so you can put the condition here, in dummy naught, wherever the month employed is greater than 90, put it equal to 1. So that's how it's going to work. So it finds the month employed greater than 90, and in dummy naught, those that satisfy this condition will turn into 1. And that's what exactly we wanted. So now if I run this line of code and run the dummy naught again, the vector has changed some of its elements. You see that some of these elements is now 1. And that's exactly what we needed, because for the second, fourth, and element number 8, we wanted to make a flag of 1 because these are the x that are greater than our naught value, which is 90. Now that we created dummy naught, we can create other variable that we're looking for, which is this part, x minus xk. And we know that x minus xk is indeed the difference between the month employed and our naught value, which is 90. So the way that I can add a new column to my dataset Reynolds is using dollar sign. So I can say Reynolds dollar sign, and I name this xdiff as x difference. So if I call this new column x diff and put it x, which is our month employed, so you're going to calculate month employed minus the value of naught, which is 90. And if you run this line of code and you look at your Reynolds again, highlight and run it, you see that now you have a new column here called x diff, which has the difference between each of these elements and the value of 90. So 41 minus 90 is negative 49. 106 minus 90 is 16. Now, I can add this dummy naught also to my data set. It just needs to add that add the name of the data frame at the beginning with a dollar sign. I can say Reynolds dummy not is equal to the vector of dummy not that we created here. So that way I can attach this vector to the data set Reynolds that I already have, and the name that I'm giving to this column is dummy not. And to avoid the confusion, you can call this DN, that stands for dummy not. So this is the name of the column that appears in the Reynolds data set that includes that dummy not variable. So I'm going to run that. If I run Reynolds again, you see that dummy not has brought to this platform. This is the same vector that we created on the top. We just attach it to our data set. Now I have these two elements. I need to multiply these two. I call it X. So as you see, when we call this data frame into R, we have an empty column here. I'm going to use this. And we multiply these two and we save it in this variable X here because it doesn't include anything. So I'm going to say, again, I call that column in data frame Reynolds. So you have Reynolds dollar sign. X is going to be the multiplication of these two columns that we define up here, which is Reynolds X diff multiplied by Reynolds DN. So if I run the Reynolds data set now, you see that X includes the multiplication of these two vectors. And that's actually the value that needs to be included in our regression. Remember, X minus not value multiplied by the dummy is going to be the part, the vector, or the column that we're going to include in our regression. Now we call this X. That's the result of all those implementation. The next variable that needs to be included in our regression is called month. So now I can run my regression model using linear model, where our Y is equal to the scales sold. So I'm going to copy this here and tilde. And you want to use month employed as one of the variable. The second variable is going to be the one that we just created, X plus X. And you want to show the data is equal to Reynolds. And also save the output into some variable, for example, regression output, and to be able to have access to it later on and get all the details in the regression model. If I run this line of code, it gives me an error. It says unt.employed doesn't identify because I skipped a month here, so I have to add month and rerun. And this time everything is good. I run this part. And as you see, these are the coefficient of my model, but I'm not sure if everything is significant or not. So always try to run the summary of the output. So, and the output is saved in this variable. So I'm going to run the summary of output, Control R. And as you see, all these variables are significant. The intercept is significant. Month employed is significant. X minus X naught multiplied by dummy naught is also significant, which is shown by X. So the model is significant, and you have a really good R-square of 90%. Now let's see how we can use this output to create a regression model. If you recall, this is our initial regression model that we are trying to set up. So in this regression model, you have month, and you have X. Your X is actually the same thing as your month. We named it as month as opposed to X. Your XK here is your not value. And this one is your not dummy variable. So what we need here is these coefficients, beta 0, beta 1, and beta 2, to be able to create our regression model. So I'm going to copy the same thing over here again, and this time replace these numbers with the output of regression. So you have 87.217 for the beta 0. For beta 1, you have 3.41 approximately. And for beta 2, you have negative 7.87. So now if somebody gives you the number of month that somebody has been hired in the company, you can approximate their sale. For example, suppose that the month since employment for a specific employee is equal to 10. Now you know that this person has been hired in the company for 10 months. Simply you plug the number into this equation. So you have 10 here, also 10 over here. However, xk is the dummy variable that determines based on the relationship of the month and the not value or the breaking point. Since 10 is less than 90, if you remember, we defined the xk, the not dummy, be equal to 0. It only takes the value of 1 if the number of months since employment is more than 90. So in this case, your xk is equal to 0. That eliminates this part of the equation, and therefore that becomes the total amount that somebody would sell if they have been in the company for 10 months. Now, if somebody has been hired in the company 100 month, then what happens is 100 is greater than 90, and therefore the flag for dummy variable becomes 1, and therefore you have a value of 1 here. Also, you need to change the month to 100. What happens in this case, you have intercept plus 3.41 multiplied the number of month, which is 100, minus 7.87 multiplied by the difference between the value of month and the breaking point, which is 10 multiplied by 1. So basically 10 multiplied by this value will be deducted from the amount of sale in this case. When you're at 90, this equation becomes 90 minus 90, 0. So this part of the equation gets eliminated. But as soon as the number of employment passed 90, this part of the equation becomes positive. Also, the dummy variable here becomes 1. And there is a deduction from your amount of sell. So basically, it seems like up to 90 month, everybody's sell in average is 87.217 plus this amount for every month that they have been hired in the company. However, when the number of month being in the company passes 90, their sales start declining by this increment. So for every extra month over 90 month, you're deducting 7.87 from the average sell that somebody sells in the company by then. That's the meaning of the breaking point, where the shift in the sell happens, where the upward trend starts becoming the downward trend. Because at 0.90, your decrease from the amount of sell overcomes the amount of increase, and therefore you're having a downward trend in your graph. Another thing that is notable here is that the R-square of this model is almost 90%, which is better than the quadratic model that we obtained. If I recall, that R-square was around 83 to 84%. And you're seeing that the R-square here has increased around 5% in comparison with quadratic model. So piecewise linear model is a better model than the quadratic model. One thing again to pay attention is that this model is sensitive to the breaking point. If your breaking point is not 90, is something more or less, your R squared might change and you might end up getting different results. So there is no specific solution in terms of defining your breaking point, but you have to pick a point that you can see where the obvious shift in the trend happens, going from upward to downward or going from downward to upward. It should be an obvious point that you can see the shift in the trend in your graph. With this, our lesson in piecewise linear regression model in R concluded. Please refer to your blackboards for your assignments. Thank you.